gentlemen. My name is Gary Schiller. I'm a clinical investigator and director of the Hematologic Malignancy Stem Cell Transplant Program at UCLA in Los Angeles. Welcome to the first press briefing of the 61st annual meeting of the American Society of Hematology. And this is called CAR T and Beyond, Rapid Therapeutic Advances for the Treatment of Blood Cancers. Before we begin, I want to remind everyone to please silence your phones, turn off the shutter sound on your cameras if you're able to do so. The studies being presented today spotlight the rapid advances being made in cellular immunotherapy for blood cancers. Cellular immunotherapy uses genetic engineering to enhance the ability of the immune system, the body's defense system against infection and disease, to kill tumor cells in the blood and bone marrow and keep cancer from coming back. Chimeric antigen receptor T cell therapy, known as CAR-T, are designed by harvesting a patient's own T cells, the immune system's primary cancer-killing cells, re-engineering them to target specific proteins on the surface of cancer cells, and reintroducing the modified T cells back into the patient's immune system to kill cancer cells. First-generation CAR T cell therapies, which were approved by the FDA only 2 years ago, primarily target CD19, a protein found on the surface of most tumor cells in B-cell cancers such as non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. These therapies have been shown to produce long-term remissions in about one-third of patients with B-cell lymphomas that have not responded to prior therapy. Today's presenters will share the results of early phase studies of emerging second-generation cellular immunotherapy products that strive to overcome the limitations of existing products and continue advancing improving outcomes for patients. Immunotherapy for the treatment of blood cancer and research in immunotherapy has been identified as one of the six research priorities for the American Society of Hematology, as reflected in the ASH Agenda for Hematology Research. The agenda serves as a roadmap for the prioritization of research support across the hematology community, including recommendations for dedicated resources from funding agencies and foundations that will equip researchers today and in the future to make truly practice-changing discoveries. The studies we will hear about now further the priorities of ASH with new research designed to heighten the effectiveness of CAR T cell therapy by designing products capable of attacking multiple targets, expand the availability of cellular immunotherapy to blood cancers such as multiple myeloma, and replace the complex manufacturing process required for CAR T cell therapy with a uniform off-the-shelf product. Dr. Steven Schuster of Abramson Cancer Center at the University of Pennsylvania will present the results of a study finding that investigational drug called mosunetuzumab induced complete responses and durable remissions in patients with B-cell non-Hodgkin's lymphoma whose disease had returned or failed to respond to a median of 3 prior therapies. New treatment options are needed not only for patients in whom CAR T-cell or other therapies have failed, but also for patients whose lymphomas are worsening so quickly that they cannot wait for CAR T-cell manufacturing that typically takes several weeks. Among patients whose lymphoma progressed with treatment with CAR T cells, 22% had complete remissions when treated with mosunetuzumab. Details can be found in abstract number 6. Dr. Bob Valamir of Fate Therapeutics will share the first evidence that cellular immunotherapy for B-cell cancers could ultimately be an off-the-shelf product that could be manufactured in large quantities. The investigational medicine, FT96, is a cellular immunotherapy based on off-the-shelf killer NK, natural killer cells, the first line of defense in the immune system. In the study, Dr. Valamir and his team discovered that FT596 demonstrated comparable ability to kill cancerous white blood cells as standard CAR T cells, and when combined with the drug rituximab, killed cancerous white cells that were no longer responding to standard CAR T cell therapy due to CD19 antigen loss. Additional information can be found in abstract number 301. Dr. Deepu Madhuri of the Tisch Cancer Center at Mount Sinai will discuss the results of a phase 1b/2 study looking at patients with relapse and or refractory multiple myeloma who were treated with the investigational CAR T-cell therapy JNJ-4528. The therapy targets BCMA, a protein commonly found on the surface of multiple myeloma cancer cells. Dr. Maduri and team found that patients treated with JNJ-4528 saw a high response rate, with most patients achieving minimal residual disease negativity. We'll hear more from Dr. Maduri shortly. In the meantime, additional details are available in abstract number 577. Finally, Dr. Yu Hu of Union Hospital, Huazhong University of Science and Technology, will present the results of a first-in-human phase 1 trial of 22 patients with hard-to-treat multiple myeloma, defined as myeloma that had returned or did not respond to at least two prior therapies. The study treatment is the first CAR T-cell therapy genetically engineered to target BCMA and CD38, two proteins found on the surface of plasma cells. After 7 months following treatment, more than 3 out of 4 patients remained in remission. Additional details are in abstract number 930. To ensure that we have plenty of time for all the presentations, we ask you to please hold your questions until all panelists have finished presenting. Dr. Steven Schuster invites you to begin, but please remember to speak loudly and clearly into the microphone. Having spoken to you, I'm sure that you will do so.